Hey. Oh, shoot. What's up, girl? How you doing? What's up, guys? Welcome to the live, the spontaneous live. I'm actually gonna do my makeup for some TikToks. So I figured, why not get ready with you guys, chat with you guys, see what y'all are up to before I film TikToks. What's up? Everyone's, you're at work, girl. I don't wanna get you in trouble. Hi, Giselle, how are you? Hey, Jen. What are all of you guys up to right now? It's probably like a lot of lunch breaks, right? Hi, Lizzie. You just finished getting ready, Ida. For what? What are you guys up to today? Yan Yan, nice to see you from the Philippines. Hey, girl, what's up? Do you guys like, sorry, I'm not trying to touch my hair so much. Do you guys like my little sweater? Mrs. Love, established 2022. Should I just make being married my whole personality now? Ken, you're about to get off work. Awesome. Being high, dealing with the aftermath of this hurricane. I'm so sorry to hear about that. I hope that, I guess Hurricane Ida has passed already, Florida. Are you guys good now? Like, I mean, I'm sure it wasn't very fun, but is it over yet, is my question. Oh. Do you guys like the music on the background? I have a 2000s girly hits on. But do you guys like it or is it kind of hard to hear me? Let me know. You getting married in 16 days? Oh my God. Latina married a white boy. Okay, well, I'm gonna get ready, but let me know what you guys are up to. I'm sorry, I'm gonna use the house live thing again. Getting ready for nothing, same, kind of. You're studying, started studying for what? What month is it? It's almost October, so I guess you're like mid-semester. I'm gonna put this all over my face. If you guys haven't started blending out your foundation first with your fingers, and then with a brush, you need to, because you use way less product and it looks flawless. Okay, so we got some people from Miami. Yeah, I'm on Spotify right now. It's called 2000s Girly Hits, which super random, but did anybody else's Spotify get hacked a couple days ago? Mine got hacked, and not only did it get hacked, but whoever hacked me, they liked a bunch of like random music. Like you could tell that whoever hacked wanted to like a bunch of music of like new artists. And then I looked on Twitter and a lot of people got hacked and a lot of people's account also liked all these random artists. So it's very sketchy. I unliked everything because it's like, why do I feel like these artists had something to do with the hacking, right? Like, what are the odds that these hackers like their music, you know? So, super random story. New York here. You like my hair? Thanks. It's a little funky right now. I don't even know if you guys can tell that I have, like, red streaks in my hair. Probably can't, but it looks really cute in the sunlight. I'm actually kind of living for it. I haven't done anything, like, fun with my hair in a while. But I feel like you guys can't even tell. Can you see the red in it? I don't know. Your Spotify didn't get hacked? Good, I'm glad. I freaked out a little bit because I tend to get hacked a lot. What are today's plans? Well, today I already worked out, kind of cleaned the house, did some work stuff, and now I'm just doing my makeup to do some TikToks. Are you guys on TikTok? Do you guys follow me on TikTok? Jen, I know, literally this morning I was like, oh my God, it's a little chilly outside, but it was like 70 degrees, but it just felt so good. This is the BK Angie Hot and Flashy brush in A507. I like this for foundation and cream bronzer, and it looks great. your daughter got hacked a couple months ago. Yeah, you know what? I literally get hacked all the time, but I finally like secured my accounts. Do you guys use like an app authentication app? If you guys get hacked, get an authentication app, because that will truly like save all your accounts. Let me add a little bit of bronzer on my neck because I feel like this foundation just looks really dark on me. Girls, who run the world? Am I the only one that likes Beyonce but is not obsessed with her? Hot take. Hot take. Do I like Beyonce? Yes. But I don't think she's, you know, Jesus. This is L'Oreal Infallible Bronzer in the shade 400 Tan, and it's amazing. Literally my favorite bronzer right now. I feel like I'm missing a lot of y'all's chats. Okay, here we go. Okay, what authentication app? To be honest, I literally just, all I did was look up an authentication app. That's all I looked up, and I just got the one with like, I'm sorry, my chat is like, sorry guys, I don't know what to do. My chat is, okay, top chat. I have no idea what's going on, but anyways, I'm not on TikTok, it's so addictive. I completely understand. Let's talk about TikTok though, real quick, because I recently came to a realization that TikTok is really good for like people that, you know, don't want to sit there and watch like super long videos, and I totally get it. But I will say, I personally feel like I am way more productive when I'm on YouTube, like when I'm watching YouTube, because a lot of the times I'll listen to like a podcast on YouTube, or if it's not like something that I need to watch, I'll just put it in the background and I'll listen to it while I do like chores. And so that to me like helps me actually like be productive. But TikTok, you have to like sit there on your phone and keep sliding. And so to me, it's like, I don't know, I just feel like it takes up more of my time of non-productivity. And so I do love TikTok, but I will say it can be really addicting, and then you like freeze on your couch. And with YouTube, it's so easy. I feel like YouTube videos are sometimes just like podcasts, and so you can just put it in the background while like you wash your dishes, or I always have to listen to YouTube while I'm doing laundry. And so that's my take on TikTok. Okay, Leslie has me in the background. Good, I'm glad you're being productive while we're hanging out. By the way, I just used the cream bronzer and caramel from Anastasia Beverly Hills. Yeah, on TikTok, you really, truly sit there and then you don't even realize how much time has passed. And sometimes you're like, maybe I should get off, but I love TikTok. Is it good for sensitive skin, the House Labs foundation? I believe so, because this is a clean brand, and I believe it is fragrance free, and it has arnica, which is good for like redness and like calming down your skin. And so I would definitely listen, guys. I feel like a lot of people forget that you can get samples at Sephora. I actually got a sample of the TikTok, no, of the House Labs foundation before I purchased it, and I've worn it like 5 times and I still have this much left. So they're free, by the way. So get a sample, try it out, because I know that it's not cheap. And so you can get samples of most things, not everything. You can't get like a sample of like a stick foundation. Well, I guess you can. One time this lady like scraped a little bit off for me. So, you know, if I were you guys, just get samples of things, because, you know, I appreciate that a lot of you guys like take my recommendations, and I appreciate that. But obviously at the end of the day, like, we all have different skin types, skin concerns. Foundation settles into your smile lines. By the way, it is 12:50 for me. I am Central Time. My favorite trick for smile lines is actually baking my smile lines. I don't like to do that on camera because it's distracting, but I'll just put powder all right here and leave it on while I do the rest of my makeup. And I even set my face with setting spray with the powder. Set it, and then after, I buff off the powder. So ideally, or I guess I'm like just drying my smile lines out, but that helps a lot with creasing because it's like set completely. I have normal skin. Sometimes it gets dry, but I don't ever get oily, which I know for some of you guys, you might be like, oh my God, you're so lucky. But like, am I? Because I think I'm just gonna age a lot faster than everybody else. Oh my God, Ida, tell your husband that I want the best for you. Was so bummed out because I, you couldn't get a sample at your Sephora? That's really weird because I've never had issues with it, and I feel like that's something that they actually promote a lot. Maybe if it was like a Sephora and JCPenney, but a regular Sephora should give you a sample. I mean, like I said, there's a lot of things they might not give you a sample of, like a blush or something like that, but a foundation, that's literally what these things are for that they have at the stores. So definitely get a sample. They put like a couple pumps in there. Hi, Wildcat. And it lasts you like 5 times, truly. So that's actually what I did when I was trying to find like my wedding day foundation. I just got samples of like the top 5 foundations that I was thinking about. And then I ended up buying the one that I like the best. And that way you're not wasting any money, or you're also like, you know, not wasting product because you don't have to return anything or get stuck with a foundation that you don't like. I'm using the Huda Beauty Easy Bake Powder. It's so good. If I wasn't a beauty YouTuber, what would you have been? What content? This is Pound Cake. Do you mean like what other kinds of videos I would do on YouTube, or what else I would do as like a job? Because I feel like that's a different question. So what do you mean? What other videos would I do if I was a YouTuber, or what would I do if I wasn't a YouTuber? Some of the, actually my Kohl's doesn't have a Sephora, so I have no idea, but I will say some of the JCPenney's that have Sephora do have House Labs. So if you guys want to, look there. I feel like this foundation went viral so quick. I'm so glad that I got my hands on it before it started selling out. But I will say, my shade was like almost sold out. I feel like all medium tone, warm tone shades are always sold out. I feel like we all have the same skin tone. By the way, guys, I did something for the first time on Saturday. I got dermaplaning. If you guys don't know what that is, it's when they use like a professional grade blade and they shave your face. I know a lot of you guys know about shaving your face like yourself, but this is like a blade that also shaves like your skin off, like your dead skin off. And so right now, I don't have any peach fuzz. I personally do sometimes shave my face for the peach fuzz, but I also don't have any dead skin. But I will say I did break out, so that kind of sucks because I did break out. But it was also my first time doing it, so you know, maybe the more I do it, the less my skin reacts to it. I don't know. Have y'all ever gotten that? Great question. Does it oxidize? I don't think so. This foundation, I do have cream bronzer on, so that maybe that's why it looks a little bit darker. Let's say if you would have not been a YouTuber, Well, my plan wasn't always to be a YouTuber, so I can definitely answer that. I have a broadcasting bachelor's degree and a theater minor, and the plan was to actually go into newscasting. So I was always interested in like entertainment newscasting, and so I always thought that'd be fun to like host and things like that. And so I do have a degree for that, and I actually did an internship, and I used to work at a Spanish TV station, so I would have like my own segment, but it was all in Spanish. It was like a local Houston network. But then I started my YouTube channel my senior year of college. So that was kind of a lot. I was a full-time student, also working full-time to like pay the bills. And then I was doing YouTube. And so by the time I graduated, I had done enough to really kind of make YouTube my full-time job at one point. And so that's why I'm a YouTuber now. What drugstore banana powder? To be honest, I don't really, actually I can think of an oldie but a goodie. This is a really good powder, really good banana powder. The Makeup Revolution Luxury Baking Banana Powder. This is really, really nice if you need an affordable, and it lasts a long time actually. Okay, I think we're done with bronzer. I want to show you guys. Did you guys watch my last video, that the one that I uploaded yesterday? I was talking about these Revlon blushes that I love, and let's show you guys one in action. Do we like the darker berry or the hot pink? Tell me, hot pink or dark one? Jen says berry. When I first saw your video, I wanted to know who you were, so I saw other videos. Oh, awesome. I'm glad you're caught up. Okay, we got dark berry, hot pink, dark berry. Okay, hot pink. Pink, hot pink. Okay, now we're like 50-50, so you guys let me know. Berry or dark? Pink. Let's have fun. I have an idea. Why don't I put one on each cheek, and then I blend them both with each other so you guys can kind of see both. Let's do that. So taking like a very fluffy brush, so let's do the pink one. So this is Pink Cognito, and it's very, very pigmented, so like, and it is so pretty. Look at that. Like this is like hot pink, but like not like the bubblegum pink, like truly hot pink. So that's like super, super cute. Love that. Obviously it looks crazy. I'm gonna blend it up here in a minute. But now let's use berry on the other side. Again, they're so pigmented. And this one, this one's like hella pigmented, and it's obviously darker for my skin tone. Oh my God. Oh my God, I'm starting to look crazy. 1 second. Let me blend it out. But see how it's so pretty? It's like a matte berry shade. I don't feel like they look that like different, actually. Actually, in person they do. Let's put some in the nose, and I'm just gonna blend both so that they look similar. But let's do that mid-tone trick. In my last video, I showed you guys, no, in my last tutorial, I showed you guys the mid-tone blush trick that I learned from a creator on TikTok. I think it's called Makeup by Lex, and she messaged me on Instagram and was like, hey, I was watching your video because I'm a subscriber, and I saw you mentioning my name and showing my tip, which it's so crazy because I was a fan of hers on TikTok, and little did I know she was a subscriber of mine. It's so funny how the internet works, am I right? So we're gonna use like a lighter blush, and I'm just going to kind of use that to marry the concealer and the blush together. I know that this is too much blush for a lot of people. I know. I've been getting that a lot in my video comments, and like, that's fine. You know, the thing is, I like blush, and also blush just like fades very quickly. So I don't mind that I look like a burnt chicken nugget. I don't have the Lunar Blush, the Lunar Beauty blush palette. I don't. What type of videos do I love to watch on YouTube? Well, I love watching beauty, of course. Patricia, hi. So I love YouTube videos about beauty, of course. I probably watch the same people that you guys watch, to be honest. But if it was anything else other than makeup, what do I watch? I don't know if I watch that much. I love commentary videos. I'm the kind of person that, I don't know if this is weird or not, but sometimes I'll click on videos that are discussing a topic that maybe I don't agree with, because I really like to listen to opposing thoughts of mine. Something about that, like, you know, I feel like we all think what we want to think, but we should always also be open to hear the other side of an argument. And so I love watching things that I think I'm not going to agree with, just to see if it'll open my mind up or make me more like compassionate for other people, if that makes sense. By the way, I'm using this L'Oreal Infallible Freshwear bronzer. Cal McCris. I actually have never heard of her. Maybe I'll have to look her up. What's your favorite song currently and movie recommendation? I just watched Woman King in the movie theaters, and so many women in like African clothing showed up to the movie, and they had the most stunning outfits. It was so cool. And that movie was just, you know, it was just such a great movie. Like, it had a really good storyline with like a woman warrior, and one of the best movies I've seen in a while. And then my favorite song at the moment, I don't know. I don't listen to a lot of newer songs. I have so many just like oldies. I really do. Does Ulta carry them? Carry what? The blushes? Yes. I bought half of these at Ulta and half on Amazon, because they have different shades. Do I have any other hobbies other than YouTube? I've really been into working out a lot. I don't know if you guys have noticed, but I've lost like 25 pounds, so I've been really into that. And I also love, I love going to the movies. Love going to the movies. You like baseball? I almost wore an Astro shirt just now. I love Juicy Jazz. Love her. I've been watching her for years. I'm telling you guys, we probably watch the same beauty people. I haven't watched Ollie Andrea. Are you going for a fall makeup look? To be honest, I was just gonna do my everyday makeup, which is like my everyday glam, which I'll do like a lot of bronzer on the eyes. And then I'll do this. This was in my favorites video. I'll show you guys. I'm just gonna film some TikTok, so. Tent to life. I don't know what that is. Do you guys hear Miley Cyrus right now? With the one I love. Was anyone else obsessed with Nick Jonas and Miley Cyrus? True crime. I like watching true crime. I've never listened to like a true crime podcast. Revlon Marvelous is my favorite over everything. What's Tent to Life? You guys keep saying that. Is that like a show? Old Miley hits a little different. Andrea Matiliano. I feel like I've heard that name. Okay, are any of you guys here around my age? I'm 28. I was born in 94. I loved, like, I was never like a huge stan of like Justin Bieber, but I do love Selena Gomez. And are you guys caught up with all the drama right now with the Hailey Bieber thing? 19, okay, true crime. Good old Disney days, yes. Yeah, so I guess, oh my God, you guys, I can't even keep up with your comments. Oh, you noticed my weight loss. Thank you so much. I appreciate it. Okay, long story short, to give you guys the tea, Hailey Bieber married to Justin Bieber. A lot of people hate on her because they love Selena Gomez, right? And so Selena Gomez is about to come out with a documentary that they have been working on for the past 6 years. So they've been filming her life for the past 6 years. And within those 6 years is that breakup with Justin Bieber when they broke up, and then 2 months later he got engaged with Hailey. So they just announced that documentary is coming out in November. And so Hailey Bieber goes on the Call Her Daddy podcast and is like saying her side, which is very like random that all of a sudden now she wants to say her side. But I just want to say, I don't hate Hailey Bieber. I don't hate Selena Gomez. I don't like Justin Bieber. He is he's the one causing these women go crazy. I do like his music. I've liked him since he first came out, but I will say he's the one causing all these problems. And of course the fandom, the Selena Gomez fandom is like, just like, you cannot say anything bad about her. Like, even when I did, I'm looking for a palette. Even whenever I did like, or I do videos about Rare Beauty, if I ever say that I don't like a product, which I will always tell you guys, the Selena, what are they called? The Selenators, the Selenators, they all come out and they're like, you didn't use it right. And it's like, you're telling me? Like, come on. But yeah, I do feel bad for everyone involved, because could you imagine going through a breakup or marrying someone and like nobody stops talking about the exes? I mean, truly, like, I would not want to get engaged 2 months after my man was with someone. No, I agree. I mean, do I think that the timeline of everything was kind of sketchy? Absolutely. But it was also like, they've been married 4 years. I mean, it's like, at what point are we gonna let them and Selena live? Like, what the heck? You know what I mean? Fandoms need to calm down. I totally agree. It's, fandoms can be so toxic, and it's like, and a lot of them think they're like doing this for Selena, but like, you're also just like reminding her of her ex's wife. Like, just like, move on. Hailey has totally made her life the drama fame. You know, some people do say that. I don't know. I just feel like the older that I get, like, I'm still interested in the drama. I just don't look for it, or I'm not a part of it. You're not in a fandom. Me either, to be honest. Like, I used to be such a fangirl of like Nick Jonas, and like, I was like a fangirl at first. And the older that I get, the more I'm like, why are we praising these people? Yeah, exactly. They're normal people. They're happy birthday. 6 years to film this is insane. Talk about reliving it all. Jen. So what I've heard is that apparently she worked with a guy who is a really good like documentary. Happy birthday. I don't know whose birthday it is, but happy birthday, guys. Apparently this guy who did the documentary is known for making really good documentaries about people's lives over a long span of time, which is actually very interesting. Is it traumatic for her? Probably. But I mean, that's what a documentary is, right? We've all gone through a fangirl phase. Yeah, exactly. I feel like, but isn't it, I don't know, some people are like older and they're still obsessing over people, which is fine. I mean, I get it, but I don't know. I just feel like sometimes obsessions that people have on other people can be like unhealthy, you know? Like, you can maybe like start worrying more about other people's lives than your own, which is like, don't do that. Like, it's okay to like be a fan and appreciate someone's talent, but like, to be so involved in drama that has nothing to do with you is like, I just think that can't be good for your mental health, you know? They keep opening up wounds. Yes, I agree. It's Sorry, I have a really hard time reading while I'm... I don't want to cut off my eyelashes during a live. One sec. You guys, I used to be so obsessed with Nick Jonas that I had posters of him all over my room. And for my 14th, like, I used to believe in birthday wishes, like, you know, and so for, I remember for my 14th birthday wish, the one for the cake with the candle, the one wish that I had once a year, I wished that I would meet Nick Jonas. And then now I look back, I'm like, oh my God, like, move on, girl, move on. Anyways, and now I like Joe Jonas better. I'm gonna stop talking about the Jonas Brothers, because it's like really embarrassed. You used to be obsessed with Joe Jonas. I hated Joe Jonas. I always thought he was like annoying. And now that I'm older, I'm like, wait, he's the fun one. Like, why was I obsessing over Nick Jonas? And whoever asked if I'm still using the same eyelash serum, I've been using the Ordinary one. I haven't touched Grande Lash in a while. They're both great, but obviously the Ordinary one's way cheaper and like, results, you know what I mean? By the way, I'm using this mascara, the Milani one. Poor Kevin, he has no fans. The thing about Kevin is he got into the industry a little bit older and married, so it would be a little hard to fangirl over someone who's older and married, right? Who's the one with the bushy eyebrows? Jonas? Yes. No drama, no wrinkles. You guys, can we talk about something for a minute? I'm getting so many gray hairs. So many, wait. Before I talk about gray hairs, opinion on Priyanka and Nick. I have an opinion. I didn't care for their relationship at first, and I obviously don't care, like truly, but this is not waterproof. The only thing that makes me a little cringe is that Nick and Priyanka, they, like, I don't get in people's business when it comes to, like, having babies or whatever, like, but they said in an interview that they did IVF to have, no, they did a surrogacy to have a baby, and they said, because we can't align our schedules to be intimate during ovulation. What? Like, I understand that people need surrogates and IVF to have kids. Like, that's not what I'm talking about. But to have a surrogacy because you can't align the time to have sex, like, what? That to me was like, I don't know. It's not that it makes me not like them, but it's just, I don't know. It just makes me feel like they're using having children as such like a privilege that like rich people can do when they don't have time or they don't wanna mess up their body. And it's just like, if you can't have children or you're having a hard time, that's one thing. But people that don't make time, how are you gonna have time to have a kid if you don't have time to make one? Like, that to me is such like a crazy Hollywood thing that, and like, please don't normalize that. Like, don't, like, could you imagine they're gonna tell their daughter, like, hey, by the way, you were in another woman's body because we did not have time to make you. Like, I don't know. That's just so crazy to me. And like, and this is coming from like a Nick Jonas fan. Yeah, exactly. Very, very weird. And like, I understand that like work schedules get in the way, but like, you need to make time to have a family. Yes, and like I said, just really quick, they said that in an interview. I'm not making this up. Very, very, very weird. Anyways, can I ask you guys for some advice? Does anybody have gray hair? I'm getting so much gray hair now. I think it's genetics. I'm 28, so it's not like I'm that, you know, but okay, we're still in the chisme though. They're stupid for giving that reason. Jan, maybe she can't have kids. I don't know. But all I'm saying is, if I believe them of what they said, and I'm taking their word as true. That's crazy. It's so crazy to me that some people would do that. Let me find an eyebrow pencil. Do you guys hear the song? Bring You Sexy Back? Okay, let's use this. Don't pull gray hair. Yeah, I don't. At first I did and I regretted it because then my gray hair started growing back and it was like very short. Oh, my mascara is wet, but I don't know if you guys can even see. But the thing is, I'm getting a lot of like really short gray hairs. Do you guys see this? And my hair is naturally curly. But because I always do my hair, my hair is just not as curly as it used to be, but my new gray hairs are coming out as curly. And I'm like a very low maintenance girl. Like I get my hair done at the most twice a year. Like I'm not like that. Like I can't go to the salon that often. I don't like paying for it. I don't like sitting there. I kind of like to do things myself until I have to go. But now that I'm getting gray hairs, which is totally fine, I really can't embrace the gray hairs right now because they're a completely different pattern than my hair that I have right now, and they just stick out. And I also don't want to go to the salon and like touch up my roots all the time. And so it's just kind of, it's just frustrating. And also I used to be blonde. I don't know if you guys remember, I used to be blonde. And so that would have been a lot easier, but now I have really, really dark hair. And so gray hairs, you can tell. And I also get comments in my YouTube videos now of like, oh my God, pluck out your gray hairs. And I'm like, no, I can't, they'll look worse. Okay, what are we missing? Let's do some inner corner highlight. Anyone from India? Anyone else from India? Okay, we're using this from e.l.f. Thank you, Ida, thank you. Now when I look back when I was blonde, I'm like, what was I thinking? I was blonde for so long. Oh my God, this song. How do you guys feel about Rihanna performing at the Super Bowl? Are we happy about that? I'm happy about that. Does anybody remember exactly where they were when they first heard the song? I remember. I was in a car with my brother and his new girlfriend in high school. Yeah, my blonde days were a little questionable. I don't know how my hair didn't fall out because I always had really, really long hair even when I was blonde, and I don't know how. You can't stand Rihanna? Oh, really? Wish I could do your makeup. Thanks. You look much better with darker hair. I agree, but thank you, I appreciate that. You can stay. Okay, so I started using this a while ago. But then I stopped because someone said that it makes your hair fall out. Is that true? And also I will say I have a very dry scalp and this makes your hair so gritty and it makes my scalp just like really dry and I don't like that. Let's do a little bit of like a shiny blush. Oh my God, you can see my mess. I'm gonna do these two. The thing is, listen, I don't listen to Rihanna like all day, every day, but she has so many hits. Think about it. How long has she been an artist? She has so many hits that Super Bowl is gonna be like so nostalgic. I'm so excited. Have each other. You can stand under my umbrella. Ida, thank you for letting me know because, oh no, I dropped it. Let me grab it. Ugh, one sec. And I do have pants on, by the way. Ella, Should we do it together? Wait, I'm scared. Okay, the problem is I'm getting all this product in there for only a couple hairs. I don't think it's working, you guys. And now my hair has like black dye in it. I don't want to touch it. What do I do? I'm trying to brush it out with a clip because I don't want to get black on my hands. Okay, the pen is better. I actually do have the pen, so I'm gonna try that because this is, I'm washing my hair today. I haven't washed my hair since Monday, so I need to wash it today. Okay, can you guys see the red in my hair? Is it coming through for you guys? What if I change my lighting to warmer? No, that looks weird. It's raining. Oh, baby, it's raining. Should we do lipstick or gloss? Yes, I brushed it out. Lipstick or gloss, you guys. What should we do? Oh, baby, it's raining. Sorry that this is gross, but I reuse makeup wipes because I don't like to waste. Was it really just a hair mask that made your hair that maroon color? Yeah, it was just a hair mask. If you guys don't follow me on Instagram or TikTok, you should, because I actually did a whole Reels video and a TikTok. Okay, you guys are saying lipstick. So first, let's line the lips. Let me find a lip liner that I really like. All that junk inside that trunk. I'm gonna make it. This is the most random lipstick, but I love it, or a lip liner. It's Glam Light Frosted Flakes. Okay, this song is a little inappropriate. Yeah. Okay. I need to sharpen it though. You guys are about to see me make my lips look huge. Yay. I live in a house. It's my window. Wyatt and I built a house, and I have a unfurnished house tour on my channel if you're interested. Oh, wait. Isn't that such a good color? It takes me a little bit to line my lips because I overline. Okay, did we say lipstick or lip liner? Or lipstick or gloss? I didn't see. What should I wear? Okay. So if we do gloss, I could do this. This is from L'Oreal. It's like a really pretty like balm. Are they even? Okay. And then if we do lipstick, let's see. I have this. Most common said lipsticks. Okay. This might be too light. Do we like this or should we go a little bit darker? I'm in love. This or darker? I'm trying to see if I have. Do we want to go fall lipstick or nude? You guys tell me. What would look good with the red hair? Darker. Okay. Let's do darker. Darker. Okay. Give me 2 seconds. I'm going to grab one. I have so many lipsticks. I need to do a decluttering video, but I really like this one from Morphe. Okay, so this is, that's not a dark lipstick. Should we do Rare Beauty? Ooh, I like this one from Rare Beauty. It's called Wise. V&A, do you ever feel behind in life? I've noticed that a lot of people around your age are on a path of self-discovery. I actually don't feel behind because I feel like I'm living a very stereotypical life right now in the sense that I'm married by 28. I have a home. I live in the suburbs. Sometimes I almost feel like maybe I went too fast. No, I don't feel that way. I do feel like I know myself a lot better now because there's so many times where I wish I could go back and tell myself, like, don't do that, do this. But the thing is, the way I think you should look at it is, this is Wise, by the way. You should never stop discovering yourself for the rest of your life. Like, you will evolve and grow so much throughout your whole life that you should never feel behind because it won't ever change. Like, you will always evolve and you should always try to discover yourself. You know, like, the person I was 5 years ago is so different. Like, I feel like I'm similar in a lot of ways, but I've also grown in so many ways. And like, let me turn down Miley Cyrus for a minute. And I feel like, who knows who I'll be in 5 more years, right? And so you should never feel behind or ahead. I feel like a lot of people are always, and like, I'm a victim of this too. I feel like a lot of people are always focused on the past or on the future. And what do they say? Anxiety is when you're worrying about the future. Depression is when you're worried about the past. And it's like, when I was younger, I remember I was like, oh, I can't wait to be 16 so that I could drive, you know? And so I always waited till I was 16. Then when I was 16, I was like, oh my God, I can't wait till I'm 21 so I can drink. So I'm always focused on being 21. Then I'm 21 and then I'm like, oh, I can't wait till I go to college or till I graduate college because I'm so tired of doing all this work. Then I graduate, oh my God, I need to buy a house, I need to get married, blah, blah, blah. Now I'm here and it's like, college was fun, being a teenager was fun, and I almost wish I was more present in that because at the end of the day, we're all getting older every single day. And maybe now you feel like, oh, I wish I was 21 again. No, because when you're 10 years older, you're gonna wish you were right here. So I guess that just be present because this is a time that is going to be nostalgic one day when you're older. And instead of wanting to be in the future or the past, appreciate the past, be excited for the future, but put more of your energy in today because your life is going to pass you by. If you're just focused about the front or you're focused in the future or worried about the past, you know, it's like you can't change the future and you can't change your past. Don't wish your life away. That's what I always tell my kids. Yeah, it's so funny, right? How when you're younger, you want to be older. And when you're older, you want to be younger. And so it's like, now I'm in this like, you know, age of like, I'm young, but I'm not as young as I used to be. I'm older, but I'm obviously not old. And so this is when it hit me of like, I just need to really truly appreciate my age, which is 28. I need to stop wishing I was in college. I need to stop thinking about where my career will be in the future. Like, just worry about today. She does look like Punky Brewster. Who's Punky Brewster? Okay, I just messed up my hair for no reason. Okay, well, I'm gonna be honest with you guys. I finished my makeup. I feel like I need some coverage up here though, one sec. You know, a moment, I'm so sorry if I keep talking about my wedding, that's so annoying, but I remember I was so stressed out planning my wedding, and so I told myself, bitch, you better be present the day of your wedding because all this work, don't worry about like are the people having fun or like what's next? I also didn't have much of a photo shoot the day of my wedding. I made a photo shoot for the Monday after my wedding where I put on my dress and we did like our couple's photo shoot because I also wanted to enjoy the wedding with everybody else. And I have to say, I wasn't stressed at all. Okay, I will look up Punky Brewster, I promise. Give me one sec. I was so present. I enjoyed my wedding with everyone. I wasn't stressed. Like, it's so funny. Wyatt's dad, my father-in-law, told me, like, you're probably the chillest bride I've ever met because your wedding is in 5 hours and you're not freaking out. And it's like, freaking out about what? You know, I just planned this for a whole year. I better have some fun. And so anyways, I know not everyone's going through wedding stuff right now, but take that advice with anything happening in your life. Like, it's fun to be excited about like future things, but enjoy your day. Okay, Punky Brewster, I'm gonna look her up. Let's look her up. It's a cartoon, Punky Brewster. Let's see, Punky, sorry if my face is all up in you guys. Brewster, okay. She better be cool. Let's see, images. Wait, Punky Brewster. Huh. You know who she kind of looks like now? She kind of looks like, okay, yeah, no, I'm looking at the real person. She kind of looks like, is it Christina Applegate with like brown hair? Do I look like her? You know who I always get in all my comments? I've gotten Ariana Grande for a very long time, but I don't like saying that because I feel like Ariana Grande fans will probably eat me alive saying, you wish you looked like her, but I do get that a lot. I actually have a funny story. I was in Vegas once at a club and this girl was wasted and she swore I was Ariana Grande to the point where she made her boyfriend take a picture with me. But she was wasted, and so I was just thinking, she's gonna be so disappointed tomorrow, but I'll take a picture with her, whatever. And then I get Demi Lovato a lot, obviously before she like chopped her hair off. And then one that I don't understand, I get Hilary Duff, which it's like, I've never thought I've looked like Hilary Duff. Like, I really truly don't understand that one, but I get that a lot in my YouTube comments, and I'm like thinking, huh? And then I also get Demi Moore. But I think a lot of the things that I get is probably because I am just like a Latina, because I'll get like Salma Hayek and it's like, do I really look like Salma Hayek or is she just Latina? Is she even Latina? I think she is Latina, but she's like half Latina, right? I just think it's funny when people tell me who I look like. And it's like, I mean, I'll take it. I'll take it. But the one that I didn't understand was the Hilary Duff one. Yeah, you could see that one. Which one? Because I just said like a bunch. Sorry if I'm messing with my hair. You sound like her, like Hilary Duff. Maybe that's what it is, because a lot of people also say I sound like Demi Lovato. I just feel like these people are so far apart from each other, and I'm like, am I the person that brings them together that kind of sound alike? I don't know. But anywho, you see Demi Moore? Yeah, I get that one. All of them except Hilary Duff. I understand. Alrighty, guys. What time is it? It's 1:33, so I think I'm gonna head off because I'm gonna film those TikToks. But let's do like a hot fire questions. Do you guys have any other questions before I head out? Just about anything? Did I miss any of y'all's questions? Punky and Demi. I'm 55. Nah, not Demi. I don't think I look like Demi Lovato, to be honest. I think maybe I sound like her. I don't know. But I still love Demi Lovato. Like, back in her, like Disney days when she had like those rock albums, I loved all those, like the La 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 Machine, those songs, love them. What's your favorite celeb makeup brand you can't stop buying from? To be honest, I don't know. I've loved almost everything from Rare Beauty, so I do like that. I think it's a very cohesive line. And that's really all I can think about. Like, I'm sure I would like a lot of Fenty. I just haven't tried a lot of it. I don't know. Probably Rare Beauty. I've just tried so much of them. It obviously helps that I am on their PR list, though. Will you do more chats about life? Absolutely. I just don't know. Like, would you guys watch videos on YouTube about chats about life? Favorite IG editing app? Lightroom. Lightroom, Lightroom, Lightroom. It's, and I have the free version, and it's so easy to, like, mess with the light to, like, make a picture just look crispier. Favorite skincare brand? I love Glow Recipe. I know it's a little bit pricier, but everything I've tried from Glow Recipe, I love. So I think overall, the brand that I love the most products from is probably Glow Recipe. They have some really, really great products. Really, really great. Oh my God, I forgot to wear my rings. Look, I even have a tan line. I was about to grab my rings and I don't have them on. That freaked me out for a second. Declutter video. Yes, 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 yes. So I'm so sorry that I haven't posted the declutter video. I'm trying to figure out what the best way to film it is, because do you guys just want to, like, see my hands and the products of, like, keeping this, not keeping this? Like, I'm just wondering how I should film the declutter video. What are you looking forward to during the fall season? The weather. I mean, Houston fall is like California summer. So I guess really I'm looking forward for the winter. But for the fall, I think my favorite fashion season is fall. Like browns, blacks, creams. Like I am a fall winter girl. Like, give me all the jeans, the black leather, the turtlenecks. Like, I just thrive with dark clothes and, like, fashion of fall and winter. I love that. It is easy, though, in the summer just to throw on a tank top and some shorts. But when I actually, like, want to dress nice, it's usually fall. Favorite places to shop for clothes? You guys are gonna think I'm so boring. I still shop at Forever 21. And I think they need to open up a new store called Forever 31. Because there's some things that I like in there, but they're also just very childish. But I also love Paxson. Love Paxson. My top right now is probably H&M. I love H&M. I have one by my house and it's amazing. Perfect for basics. And then I love, like, Levi's jeans. Those are the only jeans that fit my wide rib cage and flat butt. What e.l.f. stick did you use? This is the e.l.f. No Budge Shadow Stick, and they have shimmer and matte ones. I like to use the shimmer one. This one's in the shade Perfect Pearl, and it looks really, really nice. Hey, Samantha. You can use it by itself in the inner corner, but I always just add a little bit of highlight on top because I like it to be just, like, a little bit more, you know, intense. So, yeah. Yeah. Anything else, guys, before I leave ya? No? Okay. Hands declutter is perfect. Okay. Okay, so I guess what I'm thinking about doing is showing you guys, like, my drawers of all the makeup, and then maybe we'll do, like, a zoom in of my hands. I probably should get a manicure and show you guys, like, this is going to the trash pile, give to someone, donate, keep. And we could just do that because you guys would be very, like, I don't declutter. Like, I'm bad at that. I'm almost like a makeup hoarder because back in the day I used to, like, not be able to buy a lot of makeup, and obviously I didn't get a lot of free makeup, and so I just hoarded everything. And so it's time to declutter because I almost bought more furniture for makeup storage, and then I was thinking I don't need more makeup storage, I need less makeup. And by the way, every time I get makeup for free, like PR, I always give some to my friends to my family, and I also put a lot away for giveaways, and then the rest I'll do videos. So yeah, but anyways, I'm gonna let you guys go. Thanks for coming on my live. Wait, let me ask you guys something really quick. Did you guys get a notification that I was doing a live? And was it like a quick notification? Like, were you guys able to join the live at the beginning, or was it like a later notification? I'm just trying to see how to tell you guys when I'm gonna do lives. I did post in my community tab to give you guys a heads up within the hour, but when I started the live, did you guys get like a notification right away? Yes. Okay. Bye, Brittany. Yes. Okay, cool. I'm glad. Okay. And I'm guessing you guys have notification, turned on, right? Notify quick connect. Okay. Awesome. Good. Okay. Awesome. So yeah, you got it later. Okay. Later notification, quick. Do you guys have my post notifications on? Is that what the difference is, whether if you get it right away or later? Have a good day. Okay. Okay. Well, next time I'll do the same thing that I did today. I told you guys like 30 to 45 minutes before I started the live on the community tab, and I also posted it on my Instagram. Okay, before I go, what shade of foundation am I wearing? It's 270 light medium. That's what I'm wearing right now. So okay guys, I love you. Thanks for coming on my live. I'll see you guys next time, and we have some fun videos next week. I have a lot of drugstore makeup to try out for you guys, so I will be talking more about drugstore next week, okay? I love you. Y'all have a really good rest of your day. Have a good weekend, and be present, okay? Be present. Remember this live, guys. Be present and enjoy your day and the people around you and the weather and the food, and just be grateful, okay? And have a great day. I love you.